Now that we've learned some basics of the Final Cut Pro user interface and its organizational features, let's throw some footage onto the timeline and learn how we can go about editing our media.
As we learned in the last movie when we created a project the first time, the bottom portion of the Final Cut Pro window contains the timeline. On top of showing your project, it's also where we're going to add and arrange clips to make our final movie. Now, as a reminder, your project holds all of the information for your final movie. And this includes those editing decisions, as well as links to all of the source clips that are contained within your events. Let's see this all in action by creating a new project in a slightly different way. We'll bring in clips from the browser into our timeline by appending, inserting, and connecting them. I'm inside my water green keyword collection, and I'll select a clip close to the bottom to which to create a project from. I'll right-click it and choose New Project. I'll name the project Paradise. It's going to be stored within the event that's contained within my library with the default starting time code, and the project will be created based on the video clip's properties that I selected. Once I choose OK, we now see that timeline as well as the clip within it. Now, there are several different ways that we could edit in Final Cut Pro, including drag and drop. I'll select this shot of water pouring down this leaf here in its entirety and show that you can just simply drag this clip into the timeline and place it as a connected clip identified by the connection point. I could drag it to the beginning of the project where the first clip that I made the project from moves out of the way, or drag it to the end of the timeline. This is also known as an append edit when a clip is added after the last one in your project. I'll release the mouse, and in order to see both clips simultaneously, I'll press Shift-Z to fit my clips to the timeline window. Another way of performing an append edit is to use the editing icons. Let's select another clip and only bring in a portion of it. I will skim over this shot here, where water drops onto the woman's finger. I want this clip to start where the water drop is halfway up the leaf, so I'll move my skimmer there and then press the I key in order to make an endpoint. I'll then skim forward to right when the water lands on her finger and press O to make an outpoint. In order to see the selection that I have and play it, I will press the forward slash key to play this clip from in to out. Now that I'm happy with my selection, I'll head down to just above the timeline to see the three different editing icons, including one for append. If I click this icon or press the E key, that clip is going to be added after the last one in my timeline, and it doesn't matter where your playhead is. I'll once again press Shift-Z to fit all of the clips to that timeline window. You can bring in the portions of several clips simultaneously into your timeline. I'm going to scroll up to reveal in my water green keyword collection and select a portion of this shot here, the water drop splashing body, and settle on a duration of 4 seconds. And I'll bring in the shot just next to it by command clicking and dragging a 4 second selection around this shot. As for the final clip, I'll select this close-up of the eye and the water drop in front of it. I'll command click just when the water drop is above her eyebrow to when it falls off screen. You can see that all three of my clips are selected, and if I press the E key, all three of them are appended after the last clip in the timeline in the order that I selected them. I'll move my playhead to just before the third last clip in my timeline, and then press the full screen playback button in the viewer to play back this assembly. Excellent. I'll press escape to exit that, and it just so happens that I want to actually place a few clips in between the ones that I've just added into the timeline. I'll press Shift-Z to fit everything to the timeline window again, and now press the upward arrow key 4 times the fourth last clip in the timeline. I would like to insert this shot of the leaf, the 343854 shot. I want to have it start at the beginning of the shot, so I'll just press I with my skimmer there, and actually just skim forward just before the droplet falls off the leaf and press the O key. To check that selection, once again, I'll press the / key so we can see what we're bringing into the timeline. Since I want this clip to end up where my playhead is, I'll head over to the editing icons and choose the insert edit. Once I click on it, that shot will be added between the second and third shot in my timeline and is based on where my playhead was. Let's perform that one more time. I'll press the upward arrow key twice in the timeline to move between my first and second shot. I'll select the shot with the eye opening. A few frames just before the eye opens, I'll press the I key while skimming. And then press the O key after the eye is fully open, followed by W to perform the insert edit. I'll press Shift Z, and we can see all of our clips now laid out. Now, it just so happens that I want to also bring in some music and a title into my Final Cut timeline, and for this, I need to rely on Connect. First of all, I'll press the Home key to go to the beginning of my project, and I will select my Magnetic Timeline Library, where I have a few different pieces of audio. I'll select the Brand New Day audio, and with it selected in its entirety, I'm going to click on the Connect Edit button, where it's going to be connected to the first clip in my timeline. Now, since this audio is so long, we no longer see our clips, but by pressing Shift Z yet again, we can see the audio and how it's connected to the first clip in the timeline. While trimming is the discussion for the next movie, it is very easy to select the edit point of a clip and drag it inward to have it snap to other clips. Snapping is automatically turned on and can be activated with the N key. Now my audio is trimmed to the length of the clips that are currently in my timeline. Besides connecting audio, we can also connect titles. I'll press Shift Z to fit everything. And since I want a title to be over this eye pupil shot and match its duration, in the timeline I'll select the clip and actually press the X key in order to mark it. We can see that there are range handles on each side of the clip. I'll head over to my Titles and Generators sidebar. That just so happens that I'm on my M Title Cinematic 2 collection, to which I want to grab my title. I will skim over the Obscurity title, select it, and I'll press the Q key to connect the title to the last clip in my timeline where it matches its duration, and double-click the main title in order to replace it in all caps with Paradise. Now let's review all this. After we create a project, we can easily bring clips into our timeline by drag and dropping, or by using our editing operations of append, insert, and connect, as well as their shortcuts. In the next movie, we'll learn how clips can easily be moved around, as well as trimmed in the primary storyline, while keeping our clips together the entire time.